Hey guys, this is Anshka Gupta and welcome to my channel Let's Code and Solve by Newton's School. I hope you all understood the concept of string method in Python in last tutorial. So today we're going to study about tuples in Python, how to assess the tuple, how to make a tuple, then delete it, concatenate it, and repeat it. Before going to that, let's know what is Newton's School. So Newton's School is a platform which prepares you for career in tech. It has courses designed for freshers, working professional, and also for women with non-tech background. Newton School first trains you for 6 months, and after that it helps you out to become an amazing full stack developer. And the best part is that Newton School has a pay after placement program under which you don't have to pay Newton School anything until or unless you are being placed with minimum 5 lakh CTC. Here are the amazing companies of Newton School where you are being placed, that are Xiaomi, Lenskart, First Choice, Topper, Motorola, Meesho, Dearlite, and many more. Do log in and sign up on Newton School platform. So let's move to tuples in Python. What are tuples in Python? So tuples are almost been similar to list, that means except to the immutable structure, that means it cannot be changed. Tuples are almost similar to list part. So why the tuple are being commonly used as a string part or as a list part? Tuples are almost similar to list, but they are being using as a parenthesis in a circular bracket, not in the square bracket. So if the difference between the two is cannot be changed in the element structure, that means it has to be assigned with certain degrees or certain elements in a list as compared to the tuples. So what are the advantages of tuples over list? Why we use tuples over list? Why the tuples are being known to be the most genuine and the most recognized part in Python? So we generally use tuples for heterogeneous, that means it has a different data type as compared to the list. And the list is homogeneous, that means it's a similar. Tuple is heterogeneous and list is homogeneous data type. Since the tuple is being immutable, that means the iterating through the tuple is faster than list. Then the execution part is also faster than list. So the performance part, like we can't talk about the performance, it is mostly slightly up as a boostable part for the tuple structure. So list cannot be obtained as such a performance base. So tuple can contain immutable elements also that can be used as a key of dictionary or a key value of a dictionary, but in list it is not possible at all. Before going, if we shift to data, so data that cannot be changed, and implementing in a tuple, we guarantee that the data will remain write protected and it's been saved with the elements will be giving to the particular tuple. It will be saved and it will be consuming less data type and less memory too. So what happened if when we create a tuple, and how the tuple has been created with a similar structures? So when a tuple has been created, it has been placed in a elements, that means inside a square bracket. It's a parenthesis, not in a circular brackets, not in a square bracket. But it always been separated by the commas. Each and every element has been separated by the commas, and elements have been placed in the circular brackets, not in square brackets. So parentheses are optional. We never force, or a tuple never force us to give the parentheses in particularly separating the elements. It doesn't. That means we have the optional criteria in that. Okay, so tuple can have only the number of elements, that means it can be used as the integer, float, list, and integer list part. Okay, so writing the tuple, that means the similar example gonna be explained in the Newton School IDE. So assessing, when we assess the element in a tuple, that means then when you give the value to the tuple with their index value, so that means it is nested tuple. It can be indexed as a negative part, it can be range, or it can be try to reassign a value to a tuple. But if you are being slicing an operator in tuple, it means like you are being rearranging that. You can be separating by the commas obviously, but you are being rearranging that to apply particularly indexed to the nesting indexing. What if we have to change a tuple? So in list, we know like the list tuples are immutable. So this means that the elements of the tuple cannot be changed once it has been assigned. But if the element is itself a mutable data type like list, if nesting can be changed, the nesting can be changed only if the element is itself a mutable data type. If it's not, the nesting cannot be changed. Similar to list, we can use the plus operator to concatenation, that is to combine two tuples. This is known as being concatenation, and to repeat the elements, that is the repetition as asterisk operator. So that both are being similar to the list and resulted to a new tuple when we are going to use it as a program. So concatenation and repetition as an asterisk sign, both are being similar to the list part. So when we delete in tuple, we cannot change the element in tuple. That also means we cannot delete or remove element for a tuple. But for deleting a tuple, there is one option to use a keyword, that is DEL. DEL, that will automatically be deleting a tuple from a set of range. So likewise, the string, it has a method like, and the tuple also have the method. So methods that add the elements or to add the items or to remove the items are available only and only with the tuple part. So that is count and index. So what is count? That it will return the element item that is equal to x. And what is index bar? Return the index of first element or first item that is equals to x bar. Okay, that how the tuple is been gonna delete it, gonna start with it, assess it with certain tuple methods. So when we use the membership test, that means that if the element existed, that's fine. Or not, it will execute to the recall function. Okay, Boolean output will be given to us, that is true, false. So when we used to iterate through a tuple, so that means that we are using a loop, for loop, if loop, elif loop, whichever loop we are going to use, that is iterating part. So built-in function in with Python, it will return a value while using the function all, any, enumerate, length, max, min, sorted, sum, and tuple. Okay, these all are the built-in function with the tuple, and these all have its own description. All means like return true if the element of the tuple are true. Any means like it will be giving us an output as a true if the element is returned to the true value. Else if it will be given to us a false value. That how the build function are being used in that. So let's move to Newton School IDE and perform and create a tuple. So let's create a tuple. First of all, let's create empty tuple. Recommending this part as an empty tuple. Let me assign my tuple as my tuple and let me execute as a null part only. I'm not assigning any value to it. So when I'll be printing my tuple as a null value, here you can change also the whatever language you are being using, C++, C, Java, any. Now I'm being using the Python, so I'm being using the Python only. So let's run it and see the output. So the simple null value will be obtaining to us because I haven't passed any of the element in that. Moving forward, if we have the integer value in that. Integer, let me comment it so that you are able to understand more. If in my tuple only I have value, comma 2, comma 3, any of the value, and I have to print it again. Let's run it. So when I will be printing the integer value, it will be giving me the value I enter in my tuple. Okay, if I have the mixed data type in that, like suppose no integer, no like it contain the integer, float, string, any type, okay, mixed tuple. So my tuple is equals to any value 1, comma, then string is gonna happen hello, then float I can assign it the value. Okay, let me print now the value I have been given to that. That is my tuple. Let's run it. So the value will be coming to us as 1, hello, and 3.4. That means the mixed tuple has also been executing. So we can execute our program as a tuple without parentheses also. That it doesn't need any parentheses in that. Suppose I only give that my tuple value assigned to that is 3, 4, then I can assign any string hello. That okay, now I need a print my tuple. Let's print it. So it will be giving me the same value. It can be used to the without parentheses also. That is not compulsory that you are not using parentheses and it will not give you the value. No, that is not a thing. That without parentheses also it will execute it. So what if we are being creating the that tuple also and it is gonna give us the class structure also, that is a different thing. Okay, suppose let me create one tuple again to obtain a class. Well, then I am writing hello and after that I'll print the value that it is print and my tuple. But my tuple I'm not giving that as such similar. I'll be giving it as print my tuple type. Print type of my tuple. Okay, so it will give me the output that the class of or type of my tuple is string. This how when you create a tuple within one element that is being obtained by the similar class structure. So class structure is obviously the complicated, but it is similar to without parentheses part. So what if I have to do the indexing? Suppose if I do the indexing, let me write one more example. My tuple is equals to let me write n e Newton. Okay, n. I just wrote a Newton over here. So what if I have to obtain the similar structure by writing a tuple again, but I have to do the indexing. So what I'll be doing is print my tuple, but with the indexing as a square bracket 0. Okay. Now what if I do same as a tuple part? So it will be giving me the n output. Okay. What if I write the same part as copy, then I'll paste it down as 1, 5, anything. Let's see. Let's run it. It will be giving me again n part or n structure. That how a purpose is being done with a similar structure output 1 by 1. If I do the negative indexing of the same, suppose I delete it and I write it minus 1 over here. So the output will be n. Negative and a positive both are being done same, but to the structure as obtained to the sequence with the slicing, that means that it has to be arranged as separate operators or separate tuples. So let's revise it what I told you in the tuple as an advantages of that. That means like this, tuples are almost equal to the less part only, but we have to use them in a different sequence. In different sequence, that means it has a different advantages of implementation. We generally use tuples for heterogeneous, and that means different, and list as a homogeneous data type. But it has a good performance and list has less performance as the boost part. Okay, that how the programs are being gonna change it accordingly when you do the practice and even to experiment more with the tuples. So here is it. Thank you for watching the video. Subscribe to my channel and like the video. Thank you.